I discovered the music of Astor Piazzolla on the 4th of July 1992, the day he died. When Rai, the Italian national television channel, reported the sad news and paid tribute to the great Argentine composer, the network broadcast his music. The strikingly original music that I heard for the first time that day embodied not only the rhythms of Argentine tango, but also melodic evocation of Piazzolla's Italian musical heritage and the dissonances of jazz and klezmer that he overheard when his family lived on the Lower East Side of New York City. My fascination for his music has persisted from that day onward. This music immediately got under my skin. I was completely blown away by how profound and complex this music could be. Not only can you hear the emotional depth, a sort of darkness, nostalgia, and melancholy typical of restless and displaced people like himself, you can also sense eroticism and perceive a range of emotion at the heart of his music. There is something magical about the music which speaks directly to people. I felt I needed to breathe the air of the porteños, the people who were born in Buenos Aires, where tango is a way of life and the core of their identity. I went to Buenos Aires and I had the privilege of examining the composer's original manuscript and of interviewing people who had worked closely with Piazzolla. His wife, Laura Scalada, librettist Horacio Ferrer, and his fellow musician, Paolo Ziegler, Daniel Binelli, and José Bragato. I believe that the sound of the soprano saxophone is somewhat similar to that of the bandoneon, which is why I adapted his work for performance on saxophone. As I prepared the orchestration for solo saxophone with chamber orchestra, my first priority was to preserve Piazzolla's original concept. For this album, I imagine the sound of the maestro, the breath within his voice, and his ability to express a range of emotion. When I perform, I have a specific image in my mind that reflects my feelings. An intimate moment, a conversation with my saxophone. In the making of a record, there is both a human and musical journey that takes shape. It is the story of thoughts and emotions that materialize. It is like an open diary that the artist shares with his audience. I'm happy to share Romance del Diablo.